Good morning students, welcome back to your English class. In the previous class or in the previous video, we learned about chapter 10, the king with dirty feet from your main book, okay? In this part of the video, we'll be learning about the question answers provided for the chapter. So you can open your books as well. The questions are provided there at page number 63. Open your books and look at the understanding part. The first one is a right, true and false against each statement. So I have written down the questions over here, okay, and we just need to discuss the true and false part. The first question says, nobody wanted to be in the same room as the king. So we need to write, is it true or false? And we know that this statement is true. So we will write down
true.
Also, tell me why it is true. Why did nobody want to be in the same room as the king? Because the king did not take a bath. He was the smelliest king of all the time. So nobody wanted to be in the same room as him because he smelled a lot, right? So let us move to the next question. Question number 2. The king called for royal soap because he wanted to wash his hands. Is it so? Did the king call for the royal soap because he wanted to wash his hands? No, as per the chapter, when the king smelled a lot, for the smell to even bother himself, he decided to take a bath and he went to the river. To take a bath, he ordered for the royal soap, not to wash his hands. Okay, so the statement is not true, it is false. So we will write down false. Okay, the next question, the king's feet were dirty because he did not scrub them well. Is it so? No, the king's feet were dirty because after he took a bath, he came onto the soil from the river. His feet were wet, the soil was dry. So what happens when we step with dry feet onto, so what happens when we step with wet feet onto dry soil? The soil sticks to our feet, okay? So as a result, the soil stuck to the king's feet and his feet became dirty again. It's not because he did not scrub them well. The statement is not true, so we will write false. Okay, come to the next question. Gabo's idea of covering the earth with leather was liked by the king. Yes, it was liked by the king. Write down true. Gabo's idea of covering the earth with leather was liked by the king, and this we have read in the chapter. So look at the next question. The first pair of shoes were made by the old bent man. This is true, since we learned that at the end of the chapter, the old man tied the piece of leather to the king's feet and that became his shoe. So that was the first pair of shoes ever to be made. So these are your true and false. Okay, so the first answer is true, false, false, then true and then false. I hope you have written it well and understood the question answers well. You can see the video again if you have any doubt anywhere and write it down in your notebooks. Okay, so the next question is the question answer. So see there, the first question is given, question number B, answer the following. What did not the king like? The question number one is, what did the king not like? And what did the king not like? He did not like his bath time. In fact, he hated his bath time. So we will write it down. Write it along with me, students. Answer. The king did not like his bath time. Okay, so this is the answer to your question number one. Now come to the next question. Why did the king step into the river? Tell me, why did the king step into the river? Right, the king stepped into the river to take a bath. Why? Because he was smelling so much, because it was already a long time he had not taken a bath. He was smelling and the smell had now become unbearable for himself too. Okay, so write it down. We will simply write, why did the king step into the river? You will write the answer that way only. The king stepped into the river to take a bath. Okay? So the king stepped into the river to take a bath. The first two question answers are here. Write it down. If you have not written yet, pause the video and write it down. And we will now move on to the question number 3. So your question number 3 is, why did his feet become dirty every time he stood on dry ground? Right? This is your question number 3. Now, the answer to question number 3 will be, his feet were wet. Right? So, as soon as he stepped onto the dry soil, it stuck to his feet and dirtied them. Right? Why did his feet become dirty every time he stood on dry ground? Because the king was taking a bath. So every time he came out of the river, his feet were wet. So as soon as he stepped onto the dry soil, it stuck to his feet and dirtied them. This is the answer to your question number 3. Your question number 4 is, what did Gabu decide for the first time in order to keep the king's fleet clean? What did Gabu decide for the first time in order to keep the king's feet clean? Gabu decided to sweep and brush the earth in order to keep the king's feet clean. Okay, so Gabu decided to sweep and brush the earth in order to keep the king's feet clean. We had read in the chapter, when the king said Gabu that within 3 days you have to clean the earth, Gabu put his head in his hands and what did he do? He thought that when something is dirty, we brush it. So he decided to brush the earth in order to keep the king's feet clean. Now look at your question number 5. Gabu, I did not ask you to turn my kingdom into a swimming pool. Into a swimming pool. Why did the king say this? Okay, Gabu, I did not ask you to turn my kingdom into a swimming pool. say this? This is a question number 5. Write it down in your copies. Okay, so write down the answer now. The king said these lines. Because in order to clean the earth, write down everybody, Gabu asks the villagers to clean the place. As a result of which, they began to pour water which soon reached up to their chest. Okay, Gabu, I did not ask you to turn my kingdom into a swimming pool. Why did the king say this? Answer is, the king said these lines because in order to clean the earth, Gabu asked the villagers to clean the place, as a result of which they began to pour water which soon reached up to their chest. Okay, now there was a flood in the kingdom, that is why the king shouted that, Gabu, I had asked you to clean the earth, not to make my kingdom a swimming pool. Okay, write down the answers, everyone. This is an important question. Now come to question number 6. Question number 6 is, why was it not a good idea to cover the earth with leather? Okay, so the question number 6 is, why was it not a good idea to cover the earth with leather? Write down the answer. I hope everyone has written the question. Write down the question and answer both in your notebooks. The answer will be, it was not a good idea to cover the earth with leather because now nothing could grow on it, comma, the animals would be hungry and people would have nothing to eat. Okay, so this is the answer. Why was it not a good idea to cover the earth with leather? It was not a good idea to cover the earth with leather because now nothing could grow on it, the animals would be hungry, and people would have nothing to eat. Okay, the question number 7. How did the old man make the first pair of shoes. Okay, write down the answer. The old man took out a large pair of scissors and cut out a piece of leather. Okay, so the old man took out a large pair of scissors and cut out a piece of leather. He then took two large laces and tied each pair of leather to the king's feet to make the white shoes. Okay, how did the old man make the first pair of shoes? The old man took out a large pair of scissors and cut out a piece of leather. He then took two large laces and tied each pair of leather to the king's feet to make the shoes. Okay, so I hope everyone has written all the question answers. This is about your chapter number 10, The King with Dirty Feet. Your chapter has been completed. The question answers have been discussed. I hope this helps in your revision. Read the chapter again. Do all the question answers and learn well. Thank you, students. We'll see you in the next class.